The following is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar taking a look at third-party plugins for Final Cut Pro 10. Now let's take a look at TrackX. It's published by CoreMelt at CoreMelt.com. It's a $99 package, and what it does is it tracks planar surfaces, not points, in Final Cut Pro 10. It supports tracking text, video, or graphics next to moving images. It supports inserting text or images into a moving surface, and it uses the Academy Award-winning Mocha as its tracking engine. Here, we've got a girl dancing on a bridge. And just in case you were wondering where the bridge is and where the girl is, I've got a big red arrow that points to the girl. How can you not love it? Well, the only way the arrow is going to follow her like that is if we do motion tracking, and there is no motion tracking that's built into Final Cut. That's what Mocha does. So here's how this works. You first go to the generators, because it's stored inside the generator, and you roll around until you see C2 TrackX. There's three trackers. A simple tracker takes an external, like an arrow, and puts it on top of the video. That's what we're going to do first. Track layer and track text is where you want to put an image inside a portion of another image. We'll do that second. Let me illustrate. Just drag this over, give it a 5-second duration, put it on top of the clip, 6-second duration. Now, some number duration, it's greater than one. All right, put your playhead in the middle of the clip and select the clip. These are the edit controls. They allow us to determine what shape we're going to track. Well, is it which shape is closest to representing what I want to track? I'm going to track her face. What you want to do is you want to select an object which is close to a plane that doesn't have it go in and out of focus a lot. And all you do is you drag an area around the object that you want to track, which is this. I always want to put my playhead at the beginning of the clip, because if I don't, I'm going to end up with some problems. So I'm just going to track right around her face. Once you've got the shape set, you click the forward tracking button. Now, the tracking itself is not slow. It moves reasonably quickly, but it still takes probably twice real time or three times real time. And you just let it go through and do its thing. It's going to follow her face. Notice I don't have tracking points and I don't have any special markers. It's just following that object that we highlighted, in this case her face, because she's always looking at the camera. I've got a good enough definition of that region that the tracker can find it. And the track is done. So now the next thing to do is we'll just put our playhead in the middle of it here. And if I drag back and forth, notice that it follows her fine. Select the clip, open the inspector. We now need to insert that object that's going to go next to her. So click here to say insert. I'm going to click on the red arrow, which is a multi-layer Photoshop graphic. This happens to be one layer, and you'll notice that we have a problem and that the arrow is parked on top of her face. So I'm going to select the X offset and move it just a little bit sideways, and the Y offset to move it up, and the rotation for Y, and just rotate this. Nope. I always guess that wrong. The Z rotation, we're going to just rotate this so it goes negative 90. Y is set to 0. Good. Z is set to negative 90. Good. There we go. Now the arrow is pointing down, so we can adjust the exact position of whatever it is that we're keying to have it fit the way we want it to look. And I'll just hit the space bar. Is that not cool? That's just, I mean, it doesn't get easier than that. It's just really simple. Let's take a look at this. This is one where we're tracking a shape placed into another shape. I'm holding a white card. Now, I have tried to do this in motion. It can't be done. I've tried and tried and tried. Mocha makes it like a piece of cake. This is just, watch this. This is just stunning. Grab the track layer, because I want to track something which is inside the object, and we'll just make it the length that we need. Select this, and it says select a shape. Okay, let's put our playhead at the very beginning. That's the best place to start. Click the shape, and let's just draw our tracking shape around here and position it so we cover all the corners. Tighten this up so it's a little bit more square cornered here by grabbing the orange dot and dragging it. Okay, and a little bit bigger, right about there. We want to make sure I include all the edges of that object. Once I've got the shape drawn, track forward. This is going to take about 3 minutes. I'm going to do a dissolve, and I'll be back to you when the tracking is done. Okay, and the track is just about complete, and we're finished. If I skim across here, notice that as the shape moves, this moves with it. Okay, so again, move your playhead back to the beginning. We now need to assign what's going to go into that layer. So we click on Insert Layer, click on our clip down here, click Apply Clip, because if you don't apply clip, it doesn't know what you're doing. And notice now, it takes a little bit of time for it to wake up. But as I move this across, oh, got to click on Surface. There we go. First is to set the track. Then we set the surface. And notice as I move this across, I mean, is that amazing or what? It's just, the first time I did this, my jaw was on the floor. That's just incredible. But it isn't perfect because it's blocking my hands. So I need to create a mask. Select the object that best creates the mask, and let's just draw a mask that fits on the card. Grab this and drag it over, drag up just a bit, in just a bit. Now we've got a couple of options here. We can go back and set this to be perspective, or we can have it be translation, rotation, and scale. Perspective is actually a better choice, but you can try different ones and see what you think. Once we've got the mask set, now let's just play it. And that's without rendering. That's just... Now, if I didn't have my fingers all over the card, I could have the image exactly cover the card. But because my fingers are covering the corners, which is why I kept losing my tracking points when I was in motion. I mean, look at that. Shame on me. It makes it impossible to track without making it a mat first. But because I don't have tracking points, I couldn't really track it easily in motion. Mocha makes it easy. This is TrackX from CoreMelt. This has been an excerpt of a recent PowerUp webinar taking a look at third-party plugins for Final Cut Pro 10. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And look for Webinar 119. By the way, if you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 700 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and all up-to-date. Plus, members can attend all of our PowerUp webinars for free. Our training covers Adobe and Apple software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. And thanks.